I'm Alistair Scruton, future Earth Communications Director. I'm here with Vasna Ramasa, who's the chairman of the Earth Systems Governance Conference here in Lund, in Sweden. And we're just going to talk today in hopefully some rather kind of better weather than we're getting at the moment. It's starting to rain. We're going to talk about the conference that's going on from until Wednesday, late Wednesday. About what this conference is about. So really, to start off with, Vasna, can you give us an idea about what the conference is about for people who may not know what the Earth System Governance Project is?
Sure. So the Earth System Governance Project is it's actually the largest social science research network working on questions of governance and global environmental change. And it's set up so that there is an annual conference. The previous conferences have been Nairobi, Tokyo, Canberra, Colorado, Lund once before, Amsterdam and Berlin. It's a way to gather the whole community together, and we have 3 days of deliberations, people sharing the research that they've been working on, as well some larger sessions that have continuity to the theme and the work of Earth System Governance Project.
And can you give us an idea about what the kind of themes are for this conference?
Well, this conference has the broad title of Access and Allocation in a Warming and Increasingly Unequal World. And then within that, we've also structured a number of sub-themes looking at questions like science and activism, environmental justice quite explicitly, Earth System Governance in Turbulent Times, and then of course some more academic focus things such as conceptual understandings, methodological approaches, and such.
And what do you think has caused the best kind of debate so far? I'm already hearing a few heated words in some of these conferences. It's quite a nice, kind of lively conference. What's been some of the kind of debates that's going on you've seen so far?
I mean, I think, so for example, I chaired a semi-plenary yesterday which was on environmental justice foundations in Earth System Governance. And there are clearly many different ways to approach the idea of justice, whether it's thinking of it in a very normative sense or trying to use it as an analytical tool or in a descriptive way. And we saw that in the discussions, how people come from such different positions. And that, I would say, is actually true of most of the sessions. So we're taking topics like decarbonization and thinking about it from very different perspectives, some political scientists coming in on it, but then others who are coming in with integrated assessment modeling. Qualitative, quantitative, just the idea being that people come with their disciplinary backgrounds but have an interdisciplinary conversation.
And what's the kind of relevance of this? Give us an idea of a relevance of perhaps somebody who knows nothing about Earth Systems Governance for like topics that are going on today in the world.
Yeah, I mean, for us it's quite important that we situate both the conference but the work that this community does into what is currently happening and thinking about what's happening in the future. And obviously there are issues such as increasing climate change, things that are happening with what would be considered the post-factual context for science that are really driving us to think about how do we understand this as a single system? What does it mean in terms of the interactions, science, society, nature, society, and how do we then contribute to some of what has been known as wicked challenges of the day.
Wicked challenges?
Yes.
So that's a nice little phrase. Where's that come
there
from?
There is. I think the exact words are wicked problems, and at this exact moment I couldn't tell you where it's from.
Can you give us an idea who's coming, who has come to this conference? There's a lot of people here. How many people in total?
We've got about 250 registered delegates, and then we have another 25 students who are also participating in the conference from Lund University.
Mm. And from what parts of the world and what kind of organisations are kind of represented here?
It's mostly academic, so we have a lot of researchers, but there is certainly a few practitioners who are trying to engage in the conversations and certainly working with some of the academics in this area of work. In terms of the distribution, I would say that just because it's located in Lund, we do have a little bit more European delegates this year. And then certainly the representation is from North America, Australia, some African delegates, a few Latin American delegates and Asian delegates.
Is this mainly universities or other organizations outside the university world?
Largely universities and then research institutions.
Okay.
Yeah.
tell me a bit about it. You have a prize, aren't you, that you're going to be awarding this
year? Well, we've done it already, and it's an annual prize. It's called the Oren R. Young Prize for the Early Career Researcher's Best Scientific Paper at the conference. Oren Young, as some people might know, is a researcher who's been really influential within this Earth System Governance arena. And so he's at the conference and gave out the prizes here. It's really a means of recognizing the very good work that's happening from sort of the early career researchers, the flourishing new ideas that are coming up. So this year's winner is Catherine Rittick, who is from the University of Newcastle. And yeah.
And she got it for particular work? Or?
Yeah, she did it for a paper that she's written looking at, I think it was adaptation. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm forgetting at this moment.
Long day. Tomorrow, yeah. We'll be broadcasting actually live tomorrow morning to people interested, a special session at 9 o'clock in the morning. Could you explain what the session is?
That is right. So one of the topics that has come up, I think, in current discussions is about science and activism. And there's two elements to that. One is what we're seeing in terms of more activism just around almost supporting science. So we had things like the March for Science that took place earlier this year. And so trying to understand, you know, what is happening in the scientific community, what is happening in the interaction between science and politics that is putting science at risk, that has led to this kind of movements. And then the second part, which I think is quite fundamental, is this question of what is the role of the scientist in activism. And it's touching on the notion that there are so many changes happening in society. How do we engage with that as scientists, as researchers? What kind of contributions do we make? There's the idea that we stand on the outside sometimes and not actually be directly engaged, but rather put our ideas out there and hope somebody else picks up on it. There's been an evolution, I would say, where more and more scholars are actually becoming more normative and taking a stance on certain issues, saying, actually, we have to engage more directly with activism. So I'm really excited about tomorrow's session. We're having people talking on different aspects. We have someone who's going to talk about the activism that's happening on behalf of science, someone who's been engaged, and that's Dr. Dana Fisher. And then we have Professor Patrick Bond, who will talk about scholar activism. And we also have Stefan Nicholson, who is a Sami elder, who will join the conversation from the perspective of an activist and thinking about where and how we can contribute to what they do in their work.
Great. And that's at 9 o'clock tomorrow, Swedish time. We'll be broadcasting that live, and we'll be publicising that on our own Future Earth Facebook and Twitter feed. And we'll be looking forward to a good debate tomorrow on that from Lund in Sweden. Thanks very much, Arsena.
It's a pleasure.
And we'll probably speak to you a bit more during today and tomorrow. Thanks very much indeed.